Paganella Resort in the Trentino region of the Italian Dolomites plays host to the first ever World Alpine Rockfest, an innovative event concept that presents the world of alpine skiing in a new light and pushes the boundaries of the sport.
The World Alpine Rockfest is a grand concept and event bringing extreme alpine ski racing together with blow it out rock and roll music, best guys in the world, Bodie Miller, Ted Ligety, Carlo Janka, Marcel Hirscher, Manny Osborne-Parody, all the big names, all the winners, going after the biggest money in skiing and then having the most fun, showing you who they're all about and partying like a rock star. We picked the best of the best, and the other cool thing about it is they get to invite anyone they want, drag those guys in to try to qualify for the last spot. So again, totally different format, super fun, super different, you know, breaking the mold.
Ciao, sono Davide Simoncelli.
Davide says, I'm Davide Simoncelli. I'm 30 years old and I'm from Rovereto, really close to Paganella.
This right here, Felix Neureuther. Relaxed personality, kind of an urban guy, I would say.
This guy over there is Axel und Zwindau, the best overall skier of the last years.
I'm Julien Lizeroux. I'm 30 years old and I'm from La Plagne in France.
This is Ted Ligety. He's on the American ski squad. I mean, he's a hard racer.
This is Manuel Osborne-Paradis. He's one of the speed guys on the Crazy Canucks team, and he's a hardcore speed racer.
I'm Bodie Miller from Franconia, New Hampshire. I'm 32 years old. Been racing World Cup for 370 races.
And the world's best alpine racers have come to battle it out at the World Alpine Rockfest for the world's biggest ever prize money of €100,000. And on the way up to Paganella, they're already thinking about the race. Marcel Hirscher from Austria says, until 10 minutes before they start, I try to stay as relaxed as possible. And the last 5 minutes before, I focus and then it's let's get ready to race. Felix Neureuther says, well, a little bit of superstition always comes into it, especially once you've had a good race and you might have worn a different pair of goggles, then you'll take the same goggles into the next race as well. It's not like that you're going to race in the same underpants all year, that's not the case. But I like to get my left ski boot first, that kind of thing, that's it.
Gerne in meine linken Ski zuerst ein und das war's dann aber schon.
Six skiers have been invited by the 12 stars to race it out in the qualifications for one of the four spots in the main field. Already in the qualifiers, it's becoming clear that the level of skiing at the World Alpine Rock Fest is very high. Young Italian Alberto Schiappati makes it through to the main field. Hey, good rockers, good time riding around. Hey, good rockers, and Marc Berthod from Switzerland also advances to join the invited races. Tim Jitloff from the consistently strong American team makes sure he goes through to the main field at the World Alpine Rockfest. And Cyprien Richard from France turns some heads in the qualifiers. He skis strongly and comes in under 29 seconds to join the 12 invites. A great time that boosts the young Frenchman's confidence. Cyprien says, I've won the qualification round and I've skied really well, so expect to win the final.
I think the World Alpine Rock Fest is a great idea. We wanted to do an event that was fun and well designed from square one, and that didn't cut corners, and that, you know, was integrated family and the sport of skiing with enjoyment and celebrating and having an event.
Having the Rock Fest here in Paganella is awesome. I mean, it's totally different than what we're normally used to. I think what's good about it is the best guys will do more than just two runs. It's kind of a cool format.
Julian says this is a competition format that's a bit different from what you usually see at the World Cup. We start with 16 riders and 4 eliminated each round, and the winner takes home the 100,000 euros. Marco says, my opinion is that this is an extreme sport, especially the downhill is an extreme sport that just doesn't come across enough.
You know, it'd be good for the World Cup races, FIS, to take some notes on this and you know, start making things a little bit more of a party and get people more interested in not just the ski racing, but the bands that are going to come and more of the party atmosphere.
There's no way you could go from start to finish faster than we do with the skis. I think the forces that we're able to create in the turns, the G-forces, it's extreme.
Gunther says, we've got 200 meters of altitude, 20 gates, the steepest section's 57, 58 degrees, that's pretty difficult already. And the difference to a World Cup giant slalom is perhaps that you race on a pretty tight distance, 24 to 26 meters. And in the World Cup, it's set up much more open. We're in the sprint format here, and the guys have to race down very quickly to go home with the 100,000 euros.
Und die Jungs werden sich flott bewegen müssen, dass sie mit 100.000 Euro nach Hause gehen.
100.000 Euro waits the winner. And who starts first or last is decided at the bib draw, where 18 of the world's best alpine racers pick a glamorous model who's wearing their bib number. It's a brand new world, the glitz and glamour of Formula One at an alpine ski event. France's Cyprien Richard picks the number one bib and takes to the course once more. He could turn his knowledge of the course to his advantage. A clean run for the winner of the qualification. 29.47 is now the time to beat. Marc Bertold squeezes in from qualification, and the strong Swissman from St. Moritz is hoping to hang in there for the next round. He's making a good job of getting his edge in and keeping it clean. 29.62 is a solid run from the Swissman that should keep him in. Marcel Hirscher at the start, the winner from Val d'Isère, one of the toughest courses on the circuit, has been on great form. He's got a bit of Bodie Miller to him, fast at all costs, and the visibility doesn't seem to be affecting his accuracy. Nice smooth skiing in the fog. He takes the lead with a 29.22 and he's now the one to beat. It was a great run, and if I can come up with more in the next run, it'll be great. Perfect. Great stuff.
Perfect. Geile Sache.
Tommy Ford's another qualifier who scored points at his first World Cup, so he's a young up-and-coming talent. He skis smoothly on the course in Paganella. But will he be fast enough? He takes third so far, but there's some big guns to come. Big guns like the big Norwegian, Axel Lund Svindal, last season's World Cup winner and one of the world's best overall skiers. He's not fazed by this steep, icy course in any way and navigates through the course like a true champion. Svindal skis into second place with 29.40 seconds. Ted Ligety's an Olympic champion from 2006. Steep icy courses are no problem for this race, and he looks happy here on the course of the World Alpine Rock Fest. Over the jump with speed and style, and the defending Olympic champion takes second and a guarantee of a place in the next round. Next up is the local favourite Davide Simoncelli. Placed second in the last World Cup, Simoncelli's on fire. And he loves it steep and icy, feels right at home here in Paganella. Flies into seventh position and will advance into the next round.
I got it.
Manuel Osborne Paradis, the big Canadian from Whistler, usually trades in downhill and won't be enjoying the ice. He does look a bit sketchy on the course in Paganella. Osborne Paradis takes 12th so far and he's on the border. Felix Neureuther from Germany has won pro events like the one in Moscow in the past, but the slalom specialist has problems with the tricky conditions. Disaster. He doesn't find his ideal line, and the 14th place isn't enough to go through to the next round. Next up is the man, the legend, Bodie Miller. One of the world's most successful skiers ever, also has his problems on the giant slalom course in Paganella and doesn't look too comfortable fighting against the skis. Not a good run for him, and Miller gets knocked out in round one.
The guys are skiing really aggressive up there. It's pretty bumpy, and now it's kind of rain now. And it sticks to your goggles on the top. I couldn't see by halfway down. I really couldn't see anything. I couldn't even tell that I was right before the jump when I was before the jump.
A few of the big names are out already. Cyprian Richard and Tommy Ford coming through the qualifying to take on some of the remaining big guns. And still three Italians in there for the next round. Julien Lizarroux from France is still in there and transferring his slalom skills to this steep giant slalom course. With two medals at the World Championships, he's fighting hard, getting into the turn early and getting those edges dug into the hard snow. Over the jump, and he takes the lead with 30.05 seconds. Carlo Janka, the World Cup champion, is a technically brilliant giant slalom skier, and he's definitely out for the win today. The course is getting more and more rutted as the racers force their edges into the icy surface. The Swissman puts down a 29.78 and takes the lead. He should be safe for the next round. Carlo says, yes, I like it here. You can approach it all in a relaxed manner. There's no pressure, so it's nice to ski here and it's really enjoyable. Davide Simoncelli is the local favourite, proving himself at the last World Cup with a second. This course is similar, but more like a sprint. You need fast, powerful legs for this one. He's letting the skis drift at the top of the turn over the ice and then getting the edges in to accelerate through to the next gate. Look at the future, no one can see. There's something coming along. The hounds of LA. Over the jump and a smooth finish, Simoncelli takes the lead and will advance through to the heated next round. Fellow countryman Alberto Schiappati steps up, beating Simoncelli in the last round and feeding off the local support. Getting his timing a little off in the top section, can he make it up in the lower section? He hits his rhythm before the jump and takes second so far, looking good.
Yeah, I'm stronger today.
The first is for the boy. La prima è dei bambini.
Marc Bertod, the strong Swissman from qualification, looking to advance to the next round. He knows exactly what he needs to do. It's all or nothing. Not really reaching form this year, he really can let go here. Pushing hard as he approaches the jump, he takes fourth with 29.95 seconds and keeps his fingers crossed, only eight to go through. It's a tough contest, especially with racers like France's Cyprien Richard on the course. The giant slalom specialist who's oozing with confidence likes the ice and fog and seems to get his timing just right. The Frenchman holds his line well over the jump and looks good all round. He takes the lead with 29.62 seconds and looks really comfortable. You can see him drifting the start of the turn and then hooking his skis in to carve around the gate. Great skiing in these adverse conditions and a deserved first place so far. Next up, the big Norwegian Axel Lund Svindal. This is a skier with the experience and legs for this kind of event. Winner of the overall World Cup and many World Cup titles in giant slalom, super G, downhill and overall, he races through the fog and despite a small mistake in the upper part, he gets it back together. He hangs in there and takes fifth, but it could still pay for his mistake. Ted Ligety, Olympic champion in combined, is one of the special invites from the US. This is his game. He excels in giant slalom and thrives on this bumpy, icy course. No big mistakes, and he looks smooth over the jump and through the finish. He takes seventh and is hanging in there.
Oh, it's nerve-wracking right now. I mean, I think everybody's starting to feel in these later rounds, and I mean, this is going to be scary watching these guys come down because, you know, it's only four more guys to the next round, and it's going to be close. It's tight.
Ligety just makes it to the round of eight, but some of his colleagues who've been knocked out have already started to party. First up, the slowest from the last round, the effervescent slalom skier Julian Lizaroux. He has nothing to lose, but because of tired legs from his bumpy course, he gets pushed low. That costs him time, and he isn't carrying his speed as he struggles down to the jump. This probably won't be enough for the Frenchman. Only 30.58. One of the US's finest, Ted Ligety, a true specialist in GS, even if he is struggling in that top section where this course slopes away to the left. He loses some speed, but keeps those tired legs on the case and shows another great run in Paganella. He takes the Frenchman, but it's not really a fast time, 29.92. Coming out of qualifying, the Swiss man Marc Berthaud. You can see him fighting the rutted tracks and getting out of the racing line as he loses all kinds of speed. He won't be happy with that. There's no room for error with this level of competition. 30.41, he'll be very lucky to ski again tonight. The World Cup champion from Norway, Axel Lundsvindal's having a great time at the Alpine Rockfest, consistently getting through the rounds with a smile on his face. One of the big favourites coming into the race, he seems to take the adversity into his stride and shows why he's considered one of the best overall skiers in the world. Over the jump, and not a record time with 29.91, but it will be enough to see him through to the final.
Oh, the guys were cheering me on when I came in, that's cool, but you know, really the racing feels like World Cup. You gotta just give it all you have and see what happens.
And now Carlo Janka, who's second place in the World Cup standings. And the deadly Swissman is totally focused for this race. He gets into a little trouble sliding the skis on this tough course, but he maintains his speed through the turns and the fog with Swiss precision. And I don't know why. And I don't know why. So you think my singing's out of time? Well, it might stay money. And I don't know why. And Carlo Janka takes the lead, but only just, and he will advance to the final. Alberto Schiappati, the young Italian, is still in the mix. He made it all the way from the qualifying, giving his teammate Simoncelli a run for his money. Tired legs and a tough course, he gets hooked up and goes down. He was just pushing too hard. Disappointment for the Italian as he can say goodbye to the 100,000 euros. So it's his teammate now, Davide Simoncelli, needs to perform for the local Italian crowd here in Paganella. He came second in the last round of eight and really wants this. On form from the last World Cup, he knows this hill really well. He likes the ice and holds it well in the top section. He looks really smooth through the midsection and over the jump, it should be fast. Is it? Yes, 29.65, he takes the lead with one guy to go. The local crowd is having a great time. You can see how he gives a little up at the start of the turn, but then locks the skis in the fall line and keeps the momentum for the whole turn. Cyprien Richard is in the start gate, a definite threat, finishing in the top five in every round and winning the round of 18. The Frenchman's on fire and pushing hard, and once again he looks good on the course in Paganella, finding an almost ideal line. And I don't know why, and I don't know why anymore. Oh no, it's not quite enough to be first, but as third place, he qualifies for the final. Cyprian says, I'm really here to enjoy myself. I've prepared a lot for the World Cup, and although this is more of a party, I'm happy with my performance. And of course, there's the biggest prize money ever in skiing to be won. Paganella is hotting up for the final, a real mix of nations and talents. This could be anyone's race, €100,000 going to the fastest man on the mountain. Spindle up first, followed by Richard, Janka, and then finally the local hero Davide Simoncelli. Straight to the top of the hill for the final run, we have Axel Spindle. He was concerned with the icy conditions, but they don't seem to be affecting his robust style all the way to the final. He's fighting all the way down to the line. Rutted tracks and tired legs don't make a fast combination. Over the jump and across the line in 29.89. Not the fastest run of the day. It probably won't be enough. His friend Buchel thinks differently. You can see from the rerun he gets a little sideways, and those bumps are taking out that valuable speed. With over 40 runs on this course, it's bound to take its toll on the conditions. He's definitely not sure of keeping that top. Cyprian Richard's not one of the invited stars, he's a friend of Lizaroux. The slalom specialist has come all the way through the qualifications, and those legs will be feeling it. He's been focused for the last four runs, and physically and mentally he will be spent. Giant slalom is his game, and he's showing no sign of weakness, powering out of the gate. He wants this. Every gate he pushes as hard as he can. He looks really smooth through the bottom section, and surely he'll take it from the big Norwegian. Over the jump, and it's looking good. That's 29.57, a lead of 0.32. He jumps into first, and that time will take some beating. You can see he's getting those skis gripping well and standing strong and stable, pushing it hard right to the end. Next up's Carlo Janka, a highly successful year so far. Many bets are on him at the bottom of the hill. Strong and solid, not fazed by this course at all, but he's got 29.57 seconds to beat. He knows there's no second prize and lets the hill take its toll. His timing is slightly off, and he's a little on his inside ski, and that'll cost him fractions of a second. There's no room for error here, so can he take the lead? It's 29.57 to beat, and he's got 29.65. That's less than a tenth of a second off the pace, but he goes into second. He seemed to be fighting against the hill and scuffing speed from under the gate. That's cost him 0.08 of a second and a shot at €100,000 prize money. Just one man left, the local matador Davide Simoncelli. If the crowd could make him any faster, they would. First in the last round, he's been skiing incredibly for the whole day. He loses just a fraction on that tough top section, but still holds it together. But there's no room for error. He's an intense racer, and that's what this sprint course needs. Just skidding off some speeds on the end of the turn, he needs that. Pushing hard to the end, he really wants this win. Over the jump for the last time, can he take the Frenchman? It's 29.73, he's 0.16 off the pace. And the winner of the Alpine Rockfest is the young French skier Cyprian Richard. And he wins the biggest prize in skiing in the world. Cyprian says it's an incredible feeling to have, even if it's just money. But from zero to 100,000 euros, you wait for the other guys, and when you see the last one who comes in third and you're the winner, it kind of drives you crazy.
God-shaped hole tonight for what it's worth. For what it's worth.